free CBC News app today.
We have the solutions and ideas, and we've laid them out in detailed plans, and we've been laying them out for Nova Scotians to see, and we have the momentum.
What is needed in real people's real lives are going to be placed at the real front and center of every decision that's made for the next 4 years in Nova Scotia, and that's what's going to happen if the NDP is elected.
I've been knocking on doors across the whole province. People are excited. People are optimistic that we're on the right track, and I'm optimistic that we can continue to govern this province.
Thirty-one days of promises, plans, and vying for your vote, but it all comes down to tonight. 18 months into the pandemic, with a fourth wave knocking at our door, it's decision time. This is Nova Scotia Votes. Good evening. Welcome to our CBC Election Night special. A warm welcome tonight to viewers from across the country joining us on CBC News Network and online. I'm Tom Murphy.
And I'm Amy Smith. We will have results for you shortly, and those numbers will tell the tale of an election like no other in Nova Scotia's history. Will the Liberal Party and their new leader make it three election wins in a row, bolstered by Nova Scotia's COVID response? It is also Tim Houston's first election night as leader. The Progressive Conservatives haven't won an election in Nova Scotia for 15 years. Tonight, we'll find out if they can turn that tide. As for the NDP, this is Gary Burrell's second election, but the party headed into it very much in third place, needing to make gains outside Metro Halifax.
And one more first tonight, a new electoral map. There are 55 ridings this time, up from 51, to make room for more Acadian and African Nova Scotian representation. That makes the magic number for a majority 28.
Over the next few hours, we will have the most experienced team in Nova Scotia politics to guide you through the night. Tom and I are joined on set by Paul Withers, our senior political reporter, and Chris Lydon, a political consultant and senior vice president at M5 Public Affairs. Welcome, gentlemen.
Welcome.
We'll also have live reporters at the leaders' headquarters tonight. Taryn Grant is with the Borough Camp in Dartmouth. Vernon Ramasar is in Pictou East with Tim Houston's team. But we start with Jean Laroche, who is spending the night with the Rankin Liberals in downtown Halifax. So, Jean, when this campaign began, the Liberals had been reduced to a minority government by the departures of Stephen McNeil and the MLA for Hants East, Margaret Miller. Tonight, Ian Rankin is hoping his party will recapture the majority status he inherited from Stephen McNeil. Now, you've covered every inch of this campaign. Is it sounding like he'll get there?
The following is a CTV News special presentation.
It is just past 8 o'clock Atlantic time, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. Polls have just closed in the province of Nova Scotia. Good evening, everyone. I'm Steve Murphy in the CTV Maritimes News Center in Halifax, welcoming viewers here on CTV Nova Scotia and on CTV News Channel. Tonight, Ian Rankin is trying to hold on to the Liberal government he inherited about 6 months ago from Stephen McNeil. It is, to be sure, a calculated risk launching a campaign during a pandemic, but the young premier says he doesn't want to venture too much further without a mandate of his own. And with the fall federal election coming up, there was undoubtedly some pressure to get the provincial results wrapped up early. Liberals in Nova Scotia have completed two majority terms under the leadership of Stephen McNeil. But at the time of dissolution under Ian Rankin, the Liberals held only a minority in the legislature with 24 of 51 seats. The Progressive Conservatives under leader Tim Houston had 17 seats. Gary Burrell's NDP were sitting with 5. There were also 3 independents and 2 vacancies. With boundary changes and new ridings, there are currently 55 seats in competition tonight. We'll have more on the boundary changes in just a moment. Just over 750,000 Nova Scotians were eligible to vote today, but many did not wait. About 177,000 people cast ballots early. Elections Nova Scotia was actively encouraging this early voting, offering flexible hours at the polling places, plus mail-in options. All of this to help reduce crowds at the polling places during the pandemic on election day. So the result of all of this is a 50% increase in early voting, from 118,000 to close to 177,000 votes in 2021. Here's a quick word about what you're going to be seeing on your screen throughout the evening here on CTV. The numbers across the bottom here will be updating the party standings. They will change every 2 or 3 seconds. And then on the right hand of your screen, you'll be seeing results for every riding in the province. They cycle through alphabetically so you can follow the race in your own electoral district and you don't have to wait very long to get those numbers. When the numbers do begin to flow in here, which we expect within a few minutes, you'll probably see some fairly quick increases in both the standings and the vote totals. That's because the first votes to be reported from ENS tonight will come from the advanced voters. And in some of the safer seats in the province, that could be enough for the CTV News decision desk to declare a winner. Although our past experience shows that many Nova Scotia ridings are very close, many are three-way races, so it may be a while before we have enough votes to make any outcome projections, either provincially or in individual ridings.
Hello and welcome to Decision Nova Scotia 2021. Thank you so much for joining us as we guide you through this provincial election. I'm Sarah Ritchie. Our team here at Global News is ready to bring you the latest from the victory parties to the concession speeches and everything in between. We're broadcasting live tonight on the main network and on the Global News app on your phone or TV. We're also streaming live online. So if you need to leave the house before things are finalized, we've got you covered. Our reporters are with the three main party leaders tonight. Elizabeth McSheffrey is in Halifax with Liberal leader Ian Rankin. Alicia Drouse is in New Glasgow at PC leader Tim Houston's headquarters. And Alexa McLean is in Dartmouth with NDP leader Gary Burrell. And joining me in studio tonight to break down the results is Laurie Turnbull, a political science professor and the director of the School of Public Administration at Dalhousie University. Over in Ottawa, our chief political correspondent David Aiken is keeping an eye on each of the 55 races underway tonight. And Ross Lord is here in Halifax as well. He's going to be talking to a number of Nova Scotians tonight on a range of issues from affordability to the environment to health and long-term care. Now, before those results start pouring in, just a quick explanation about what you're seeing here. If you're watching online, you can click on your riding for updated results anytime. For those of you watching on TV or on the app, you can see the L frame here on your screen. And this is where we're going to show you live results as they're reported by Elections Nova Scotia. So the bottom of your screen, this is where you'll see overall standings. Each of the parties is trying to get to 28 seats tonight. That is majority territory. Along the side, you'll see results for each of the 55 individual ridings. Now, before those results start coming in, we want to take a look at where the Nova Scotia legislature was before the writ dropped on July 17th and where we'll be tomorrow.
Interesting to note now that Mr. Burrell is tied with Mr. Rankin in the seat count at this point. And on the basis of the numbers as they're coming in, we are ready to make a call here at just after 9 o'clock Atlantic time. We are projecting a progressive conservative win in Nova Scotia. So once again, it is too early to determine whether it will be a majority or a minority government, but CTV News is projecting a change in government, a progressive conservative win in Nova Scotia. Tim Houston will become the next premier of Nova Scotia. What remains to be seen is whether he will lead a majority government or a minority government. As you can see, he's right on the cusp with 27 seats. Heidi Petrochek is in a very happy room in Pictou County.
I just want to interrupt here for a quick moment, folks, because the CBC Decision Desk is prepared to make a projection about who will form the next government of Nova Scotia. And it will be, in fact, a PC government. 15 years in the political wilderness, and Tim Houston is going to be going to Province House leading a progressive conservative government, Paul.
Good heavens, the conservatives are back in for the first time in 15 years out of the wilderness. We don't know yet whether he's going to push it over that 27
number. Some fist pumping there for sure.
So there should be.
Yeah, that's a really, as we were saying leading up to this, a pretty incredible night for the PCs, who, you know, were accredited for having run a very strong campaign. And it looks like it paid off.
Yeah, you can see the jubilation there. I know it's early, but they are seeing a trend, of course.
If that's what happens.
Okay, hold that thought, Lori. We're going to come back to this, but we do have some breaking news we want to get to tonight. Global News is projecting a progressive conservative win this evening. Now, it is too close to call at this point. It's too early to say whether the PCs will be able to form a government. There are some very close races, and as we've been talking about, these are still very tight races across the province in many areas. Let's take a look at where they are. These are the tight races that could determine whether Tim Houston and the PCs could form a majority government.
So Aaron, I'm just going to jump in, and I apologize, but we have a very important call to make. The CTV News Election Decision Desk is now set to make the call for progressive conservative majority government in Nova Scotia. Nova Scotians have elected Tim Houston, the 30th Premier of Nova Scotia, and he will do it with a majority government. So this is the first progressive conservative majority in a generation. Heidi Petrochik is with the PCs at headquarters in Halifax. They're happy.
Well, that concludes our coverage of this 41st general election here on Decision Nova Scotia 2021. The PC party has won. We do not know whether they'll form a majority or minority government, but Tim Houston will likely form the next government. On behalf of all of my colleagues across the province and everyone behind the scenes,
at Product Care Recycling, we know paint makes our world a...
All right, thanks, Shana. Yeah, you can certainly hear the excitement in her voice there. Look at the scoreboard there, the PCs leading or projected elected in 31. It has certainly been their kind of night tonight. And now the CBC Decision Desk is prepared to make another projection about the government of Nova Scotia. And it will, in fact, be a progressive conservative majority government. They are now over the top and into majority territory, heading back to Province House with a commanding control of politics in this province tonight, Paul.
Well, that's the cherry on top of the cake for Tim Houston tonight. It's now mission accomplished on all fronts. He is safely in charge of the Nova Scotia government. The keys to Province House, the keys to government are in your hands, Tim Houston. And, you know, why can we make this projection? Well, it was actually John White in Glace Bay that gave the decision desk the comfort to go ahead with that win in the column. Whatever happens elsewhere, it's pretty clear now that that Tim Houston has the majority that he needs, whatever happens in those other ridings.